Okay, I'd like to call to order the June 26, 2013 meeting of the East Chicago Board of Works, Public Works. Roll call.
Val Gomez.
Present.
Jezreel Rodriguez.
Present.
Carla Morgan.
Present.
Okay, we're gonna skip minutes because we'll do that next meeting. We'll put the minutes of the last meeting for next meeting. Correspondence. We have a notice of public hearing. Notice of public hearing, City of Chicago Board of Public Works. Reference 4901 Alexander Avenue, Chicago, Indiana. See, dear. What is this? Jason property owner, you're hereby notified as a Jason property owner that the Board of Zoning Appeals will hold a public hearing on Monday, July 1st, 2013 at 5 p.m. in the Common Council Chambers, second floor, in Chicago City Hall, 4525 Annapolis Boulevard, on the following. The Chicago ordinance mandates that when a business or persons want to conduct a business or development that is listed in ordinance number 000016 as a use needing a variance, a petition to the BZA and a public hearing are necessary. The petitioner has requested that the Board of Zoning Appeals conduct a public hearing to solicit public input from any adjacent landowner who own property within 300 feet of the site and other interested parties to allow the site 4901 Alexander Avenue to operate a restaurant. Consideration of petition action. A petition for a variance of land use within an R3 zoning district, multiple dwelling and or two-story row house on the property commonly known as 4901 Alexander Avenue, East Chicago, Indiana, 46312. The variance is to permit the operation of a Subway restaurant. You or your representative may appear at the above time to voice comments concerning the petition. A copy of the BZA petition is on file in the Planning Department at 4444 Railroad Avenue, Chicago, Indiana. Written comments filed with the Planning Department will be forwarded to the BZA for consideration at the public hearing. If necessary, the public hearing may be continued by the Board of Zoning Appeals. Respectfully, Richard Morrisrow, AICP City Planner. Okay, that's our only correspondence. Doesn't require any action.
No.
Okay, that brings us to new business. We're going to have a little change. We're going to have, first thing on agenda will be the signature of title paperwork for Berrien Avenue reconstruction plans. Want to speak on that?
Yeah, here we have a representative from American Structure Point, so he can explain, you know, why we need this signature and, you know, the reason of this item in the agenda. So,
Glenn Campbell with American Structure Point. I'm here today for requesting signature of the title page for the Berrien Avenue reconstruction project. This is a project that East Chicago has been working on for several years, and we are scheduled for letting September 11th of this year. So board approval of the plan, saying it's okay to go forward and that the money's there, is part of the requirement for this NDOT project. And therefore, we're just requesting your approval and signature of the title page.
Okay. Any questions? Or?
No.
No? I'll entertain a motion for board approval of the for signing of the title paperwork for the Berrien Avenue reconstruction plans.
So move.
Second.
Roll call.
Val Gomez.
Yes.
Jezreel Rodriguez.
Yes.
Carla Morgan.
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Okay, next on our agenda, we have resolution 2013-08, which is a resolution to the Chicago Board of Public Works transferring certain real property located at 5018 Alexander to the Chicago Redevelopment Commission.
Okay. Do you want me to touch on this? Or?
Yes.
Okay. This basically is just approving that we transfer title to this property for $1, I believe, from the Board of Works to the Redevelopment Commission. I believe the Redevelopment Commission has a plan for this particular parcel. I'm not familiar with what the redevelopment plans are, but that's why they're asking for it. So if we pass this, We'd have to sign the deed, which is, I think the third page is behind it, the longer sheet of paper. And then send this over to the Redevelopment Commission. They would also have to adopt a similar resolution accepting it, and then they have to give us a dollar. So that's it in a nutshell. Like I said, unfortunately, I don't know what the plans are for that parcel, but we've transferred other parcels to them to facilitate mm-hmm. development projects.
But we would have to sign a quick claim deed?
Yeah, so we're just deeding over whatever interest we have in that parcel to redevelopment.
Okay. Any further questions on this issue?
No.
No? Then I'll entertain a motion that we pass resolution 2013-08, transferring of certain real property located at 5018 Alexander to the Chicago Redevelopment Commission.
So moved.
Second.
Roll call.
Val Gomez.
Yes.
Jezreel Rodriguez.
Yes.
Carla Morgan.
Yes.
Okay. Next on agenda is resolution 2013-09. And this is a resolution of the Chicago Board of Public Works declaring certain obsolete and unused vehicles and equipment as surplus and authorizing a sale. This is for auction. Do you have any?
Yeah. The auction has been set up with our central services, the Public Works Department. And so what's necessary before the auction, and this is actually a live auction, mm-hmm. As opposed to the other ones we've done were online. So what's necessary before we can auction off city equipment is this board has to declare it surplus. Mm-hmm. And so what happened is the department went around and found equipment, mostly vehicles that the city no longer has need of, or they're obsolete for city purposes, like old police cars and that kind of thing. So this lists the vehicles and equipment by VIN number. So if we approve it, then we're authorizing the auction. That they've already worked out the details on the auction.
Okay. Any further questions or?
No further question.
Yeah.
If there be no further questions, entertain a motion to approve resolution number 2013-09, resolution of the Chicago Board of Public Works declaring certain obsolete or unused vehicles and equipment as surplus and authorizing sale of.
So moved.
Second it.
Roll call.
Val Gomez.
Yes.
Jezreel Rodriguez.
Yes.
Carla Morgan.
Yes.
Okay, next we have approval of invoices for STM Enterprises. I could speak on this. These in a previous meeting we passed an agreement with STM for enhancement of certain, I think we listed 10 parks. This is a continuation of that agreement. And here, as part of the agreement, he's supposed to report, the invoice is supposed to be brought to the Board of Works. And these invoices cover Kosciuszko Park for the amount of $1,998. Todd Park for the amount of $1,245. Goodman Park for the amount of $1,302. Raleigh Park for the amount of $1,380. I think that's it. This is for the enhancement and maintenance of services rendered. The mayor and I have gone over these, and we have approved these as they came in. Mm-hmm. I think I missed one. There's another one for Kosciuszko for $1,093.50. So there was two for Kosciuszko. Any questions on these?
Yeah, I have a question. Are these invoices in addition to the rates that we approve, or I think we approve specific amount of money per park or something like that, or I think we approve an agreement certain.
I remember we did approve some for cutting, mm-hmm. and these are more enhancement. Where
is this different?
Mm-hmm. Okay. This is almost like for spraying of weed weed killer, providing clearing out weeds, putting mulch down, in certain cases removing some plants, replanting other plants.
So this basically is different, a different scope of what we approve.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And one more thing, it's who it's overseeing this work. It's a park, it's a public works mm-hmm. department.
We have our new director of public works.
Mm-hmm.
He is actually in contact with her, and they go over a project to make sure if, in case our people can do something, mm-hmm. like right now our people are still cutting, and he's doing enhancements.
Okay, I just have a suggestion maybe for future invoices.
Mm-hmm.
If whoever is inspecting this work can initiate the bill, will be easier for us to approve it, because I mean I'm pretty sure you don't have the time.
Right. I think usually when we submit it to the controller's office, the mayor he signs off on it,
mm-hmm.
and he sends it over to the controller, and I had the controller send it over here,
mm-hmm.
so I wanted it to be read here in the public.
Okay.
But we can do that. We can have the mayor's approval and my approval on there.
Okay. Or if it'll
mm-hmm.
be the public works director.
Whoever's supervising this work, maybe.
Yeah, if you recall, when we passed ours enhancement program, it was only supposed to go for, I think, this month.
Mm-hmm.
And then after that, once our public works new director became more, you know, secure in her duties, and then she would take over this.
Okay,
so I'm hoping we only do a few more of these, and then it'll be transferred over there.
Yeah, and then in future years, everything should be on the schedule, so we won't have to
mm-hmm.
do extra emergency mm-hmm. kind of work like
yes,
this was.
The reason for this, we were getting a lot of calls from councilmen and the public
mm-hmm.
on the condition of the parks. We had a very severe issue there, so. Any other questions?
No.
Okay, then I'll entertain a motion that we approve it. Invoices from STM Enterprises.
I move that we approve invoice from STM, invoice number 052413-1319 to 052813-1322.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Second motion.
Roll call.
Val Gomez.
Yes.
Jethro Rodriguez.
Yes.
Carla Morgan.
Yes.
Okay, next on our agenda is from...
I believe they're 24.
Mm-hmm.
You say through 1322?
The last one in my pile was 1322, but you're right there out of order.
Yeah, I see.
So, would you like me to redo the motion?
Yeah. And I don't see 23 here.
19, 20, 21, 22, and 24. There's no 23 here.
There is no 23, yeah.
I'd like to rescind my previous motion and redo it.
Yep. That's fine.
Okay. I move that we accept the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 invoices from STM Enterprise that are numbered, and I'll read the last four digits of each invoice. Invoice number 1319, 1320, 1321, 1322, and lastly, invoice number 1324.
So move.
Roll call.
Val Gomez.
Yes.
Jethro Rodriguez.
Yes.
Carla Morgan.
Yes.
Okay, next on agenda from NIES Engineering, Todd Avenue Reconstruction, the change order.
Yeah, this is unfortunately another change order for Todd Avenue reconstruction project. This is a NIES engineer. They were hired by this board to do the design of this project, and basically the original scope of this project was just water main and mill and pave and 88 curb ramps. So there were two sections of pipe that couldn't be lined on the relining project, and we would like to replace those lines. We don't want to mill or pave if we don't fix the sewer. So we're going to eliminate those sections from the relining project. We'll get a credit for that. And I asked NIES Engineering to include a replacement of this section on the project that we're gonna let next month, and that's additional scope, and they're asking for an increase of their contract for the amount of $1,800. Is there any questions?
Let me see if I have it. For the amount of $24,505?
That will be the total, but for this
one. Oh, this one's for $1,800.
Yeah, the previous contract price was $24,505.80. If we add that $1,800 will be a total of $26,305.80. So they're asking for an increase of $1,800.
Okay. Any further questions?
No.
No? I entertain a motion that we accept the change order from NIES Engineering for the Todd Avenue reconstruction for the amount of $1,800.
So moved.
Second it.
Roll call.
Val Gomez?
Yes.
Jezreel Rodriguez?
Yes.
Carla Morgan?
Yes.
Next agenda, we have another one from NIES Engineering for engineering services for engineering building and central receiving parking lot paving project.
Yeah, this is a proposal. We request, I contact several companies and I ask for a proposal for a resurfacing. We would like to resurface the annex building, engineering department. Replace curb ramps, ADA curb ramps, and also do the same thing on central services. That will be the main scope. Also, part of the proposal was install a new fence around the annex building. The existing fence, it's in really bad shape. That will be part of the scope as well.
Is that the fence around the back of the building or the chain link?
Yeah, the chain link fence.
And it's fallen a couple times in storms and
many times. So yeah, we would like to replay that with a rock iron fence and some kind of brick pillar columns. That will be part of the scope. They're gonna prepare plan and specs. They're in central services. They're an area that has some drainage issues, so they will have to do some surveying and engineering as part of this project. And basically, this company was one of the lowest. There were two companies very close as far as the fees, and they have been doing work for us. Is there any question about the scope, the fee? Basically, here's the proposal with all the scope. I think it's a reasonable fee. The total, they're asking for $18,400. Actually, they were the lowest bidder. The second one, but they were the lowest.
So it's not to exceed that amount?
Not to exceed that amount.
When would they complete their planning and design work, and when will we bid out the actual work?
This year. I think between 30, 60 days, they can finish plan and spec, and maybe we can go for bits, but definitely the work will be done this year.
Okay.
Any other questions?
No, not for me.
I'm going to take a motion for NIES Engineering for proposal for engineering services for engineering building and central receiving parking lot payments for planning and design work.
So move.
Second.
Roll call.
Val Gomez?
Yes.
Jezreel Rodriguez?
Yes.
Carla Morgan?
Yes.
Okay, next we have a proposal for Guthrie 136 resurfacing project.
Yeah, this was another proposal.
I contact different companies and I receive around maybe 4 or 5 different proposals. The scope of this project basically will be just resurfacing and the replacement of ADA ramps, curb ramps. And will be at Guthrie Street. And there is a, I think there is a section on 136, it's in really bad condition. We're gonna resurface that as well. SEH, they were the lowest bidder. I would say the lowest proposal. They're asking for a lump sum fee of $15,000. Is a reasonable price for this kind of work. They're gonna prepare plans, specs, review and recommend an improvement of stormwater infrastructure, including curb, inlet, catch basin, manhole pipes. What else? Basically, that's it. Create plan and specs. And also, we it's something that we would like to do this year as well. So they're gonna work hard on this if they are selected, and there's a good chance to do this project this year as well. I think they think maybe 45 days they can finish the plans and specs, and maybe we can go for bids later this year.
Okay. Any other questions?
Nope.
I entertain a motion to submit the proposal from SCH for $15,000 for to provide engineering design services for Guthrie and 136th resurfacing project.
So move.
Second.
Roll call.
Val Gomez?
Yes.
Jezreel Rodriguez?
Yes.
Carla Morgan?
Yes.
Okay, next we have from 145th Street Reconstruction, Weaver Booz, change order?
Yeah, this is a change order request. We had a kickoff engineering department, sanitary district, water department had a kickoff meeting with Weaver Booz. Maybe a week ago, and we went through, you know, all the scope and everything. They asked us if we want to include basically that's what's the name of this street?
The Geneva Glen.
Yeah, the Geneva Glen. That was not a original part of the original scope of this project, and they asked if we want to resurface that cul-de-sac, and I think that's a great idea. We're gonna do 145th. We don't want to leave anything, you know, there that cul-de-sac connect with 145th. So, and they, I asked for a proposal. They asking for additional compensation for $3,400 to provide additional surveying and alternative study design and construction document for that cul-de-sac. And so I think it's a good idea if we add this as part of this project.
So this is just for the design work?
Yes, they start surveying this this week. Right now, if we're going to prove this is a perfect time, so we can just tell them, you know, go and do it, otherwise they want to come back, and so.
Okay. I have a question. That area has kind of newish houses, and like the houses aren't more than 10 years old over there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I just wondered.
Yeah, actually, there's some, you check the GIS, there's some, you won't see some of those houses.
That's how new they are.
In the GIS, in the Lake County GIS system.
The developer who did it then didn't have to, like, that street had been there, or, I just wonder if the past developer had any responsibility for the street to, you know, like, a certain quality of concrete or anything where we could go back and maybe recover.
No, I mean, the streets belong to the city. It's our right of way. So the contract, whoever did that, those houses,
build those houses, they're not responsible for.
Okay, so the city did the street and the.
I'm pretty sure we did it. Okay. Long time ago.
All right, I just wonder.
Okay, any other questions? No.
No.
Entertain a motion. Change order request for design and construction plans added to the resurfacing of Glen Court under the 145th Street Reconstruction Project.
So moved.
Second.
Roll call.
Val Gomez.
Yes.
Jezero Rodriguez.
Yes.
Carla Morgan.
Yes.
Okay, next on agenda, we have a memorandum of understanding with Everybody Counts Center Independent Living.
Okay, I can discuss that a little bit. The city's made an effort to have a uniform policy, or fairly uniform policy, when it comes to outside organizations who use space within city-owned property. In particular, our community centers and park properties and other like public buildings that the city maintains,
mm-hmm.
Because there wasn't a uniform policy before, which in some cases left the city kind of open to problems and issues. So Everybody Counts is an advocacy group. They help people who are impaired, physically handicapped, and have other difficulties. Okay.
I don't know how that was.
All right, let me hurry up and finish then. They advocate basically for people who are in need in our community. They've been doing that work for years now. And they would like to use space in our Clemente Center just to house a local office, which would give our residents better access to them as an agency. And so the city is agreeable to letting them use an office in Roberto Clemente Center, and that's already been identified and all that. And then obviously use bathrooms, have periodic access to a conference room, provided that they are responsible. They'd be liable for anything that happened in their space. They have to respect the rules that the city sets for use of the center and hours of access and that kind of thing. They can't sublet the space out. This is a year-to-year agreement, so it's for a one-year term, and it's renewable as long as neither party cancels. But we also have a 30-day out, so either side could give the other side 30 days notice of the intent to discontinue this agreement. So are there any questions at all on this?
No.
And it's basically for free, because they're a not-for-profit. The folks they serve, they're not a they don't have a huge budget to do this.
Mm-hmm.
So
any other questions or comments?
No.
I'm going to take a motion. We accept a memorandum of understanding with Everybody Counts Center for Independent Living for use of space in city-owned property, in particular the Roberto Clemente Center.
So moved.
Second.
Roll call.
Val Gomez.
Yes.
Jezero Rodriguez.
Yes.
Carla Morgan.
Yes.
Okay. Next we have the right-of-way applications from the engineering department.
Yeah, we only have one application. It's a permit number 13-02079. It's a right-of-way. Applicant Tika Enterprises, address 3902 Main Street, and description roof replacement. That's the only application.
Okay. Any questions on that application?
Just which thoroughfare they're going to block? Just Main Street and not the side street? And is it going to be? I see it goes basically.
Yeah, you're okay.
This week.
I can't remember. It's east or west side of Main Street.
Okay. I just wonder. They're like on the south. I guess it's the southwest part of that intersection.
Mm-hmm.
So I just wondered, are they going to actually block the street or just the sidewalk? I asked just because it's a busy area.
Will be only the street.
Okay, but people can, like, traffic will be able to get around them.
Yeah.
They're going to block traffic in either direction. Okay, no other questions.
Okay, there be no other questions or comments. I entertain a motion to accept Board of Public Works permit application number 13-02079.
So moved.
Second.
Roll call.
Val Gomez.
Yes.
Jezreel Rodriguez.
Yes.
Carla Morgan.
Yes.
Okay, that brings us to old business. You recall from last meeting we had 3 quotes for security at City Hall. I reviewed the 3 quotes, and everything being equal, the lowest bid was from ISM, and that was for $11.50 for regular hours, $17.25 for anything special. The other two were, one was from Midwest for $12.95 and $19.42, and the final one was from Securitex for $12.16 and for $18.24. So ISM being the lowest at $11.50 and $17.25. I'd like to entertain a motion that we accept the proposal for ISM for security services at City Hall.
So moved.
Second.
Roll call.
Val Gomez.
Yes.
Jezreel Rodriguez.
Yes.
Carla Morgan.
Yes.
Now it brings us to other business. Any other business from the commissioners? Okay, our next regular meeting will be Wednesday, July 10th, 2013 at 4:30 p.m. There being no other business, I entertain a motion for adjournment.
So moved.
Second.
Roll call.
Val Gomez.
Yes.
Jezreel Rodriguez.
Yes.
Carla Morgan.
Yes.
That's it. Thank you.
Thanks.
Are you just going to report on what's...
That's fine.
We can call at the beginning of... Do you have anything to hand out that you want to, or? Right. Have you been talking to, you know, James?
I called him. And then he called, and I told him from just giving him the news and everything. And I found out that he said I still can't see her. Is that correct?
Yeah, it was set for a status.
Right.
30-day status. Last right. time she came, she had to be...
Right.
And she was going to try to obtain some subcontractors.
Right, and I told him that I would write out an outline for what I have.
May we put her near the top of the agenda? She didn't seem to be on the agenda, even though it's a continuous.
Building department status report, we have 4 properties.
Do you have extra copy of that building? I don't think I have that. Or you're going to?
Yeah, it was just a status report on the 4 demolition properties.
But are you going?
Addresses?
Well,
I was going to orally give the report. But.
Huh. I guess she usually ends up. She's.
Do you have a written report too?
Yeah.
They have a written report from Ms. Guzman.
Okay.
We didn't have anything.
No, no, that's fine. She's going to give us something that she has.
Right.
So that'll be.
Yeah, if you'd like, I can list the addresses that we're here on. Would that help at all for the agenda?
Probably better just to speak to them, and then they'll Olga will get them for the record rather than just giving them to us beforehand.
Okay, that's fine.
Yeah. Why don't we begin then, if we could? We'd like to welcome everyone. This is the East Shakota Board of Public Safety. A regular meeting we're going to call to order, beginning with the Pledge of Allegiance.
Pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Roll call.
Richard Morrisrow.
Present.
Tom Thomas Davis.
Present.
Richard Trumzinski.
Present.
The minutes from our last meeting of June 12th. Any questions from either of our commissioners?
No question on that for me.
Accept a motion to adopt.
Motion to accept.
I second the motion.
Roll call.
Richard Morrisville.
Accept.
Thomas Davis.
Accept.
Richard Trumzinski.
Accept.
Any correspondence?
No, we do not.
I have one letter from Mrs. Raquel Garza in regard to the 5017 Indianapolis Boulevard property. I would rather it not become part of the record, however, in that she's represented by attorney Lonnie Randolph. I will hold on to the letter, but in that since she has been represented by counsel, that we deal through her attorney rather than trying to deal both with her as an individual and as a represented person. Mr. Smith, do you think that's acceptable?
Yes, sure. I believe that probably is an acceptable manner. I mean, you're not making it part of the record. You're going to respond to Attorney Randolph.
Right. Is hers one of the properties, four properties you have?
It is not.
You're shaking your head.
Indianapolis is not.
You're shaking your head, James, in some...
It's on a status, it's not on a demolition.
Okay, that's fine. I also mentioned then the next thing for new business, we're going to have, if you would come forward and just to give us about 3902, just introduce yourself and then tell us what the status is.
Okay, it's Stel Powell on behalf of Pericle Consulting Firm with regards to the owners of the property at 3902 Grand Boulevard, East Chicago. I prepared a outline of what I have already lined up to get done. Do you want me to present it to you or to him?
Present it. Do you have enough copies?
I have a copy for myself and a copy for her.
Why don't you just show it to Mr. Smith and he'll give it to us then, unless there's some reason. Mr. Smith, if you'd like to have James make a copy and put it with your records and have him get the original to us, we'll just mention. Is that okay?
Yes.
And then why don't you give us the content, Ms. Powell?
Okay, at present, I've already lined up and scheduled to have the building cleaned out beginning on July 20th. I'm sorry, that's a mistake. July 20th, 2013. I'm going to secure the dumpster from Total. Then I'm going to have the premises secured with regards to replacing the entry door so that we would have easy access in and out. Replacement of the broken windows and removal of all the boards in order to start working on the property. I have already entered into negotiations with a contract with Telles Construction Company for much of the outside work.
That's T-E-L-L-E-Z?
T-E-L-L-E-S.
E-S, okay.
Telles. He will do complete new roofing on both the main structure and the garage, and that would be a shingle roof. He will install all new gutters and downspouts, all soffits and fascia. He will repair all the concrete stairs and rebuild the brick walls on either side of those concrete stairs. And he will do all the necessary tuck pointing and replacement of damaged bricks and missing bricks on both the main structure and the garage. We have also talked about him, some portions of the building, like the dormers on the main structure, needs aluminum siding. He will do that also.
If we may invite Mr. Portolatine to, or Mr. Smith, whichever.
Sure. The board, the only concerns we have about this is that Mrs. Powell, I'm sorry, her Parkley consulting firm use licensed contractors, and it appears, at least from just an initial discussion, that Telles is not licensed in the city, and so we would like to...
Are you sure? Because they did work for me on the structure I'm in now. They did this last year. They secured the permit and the licenses from the city.
Well, let's just say that if they are, great. I just want to make sure that our recommendation and request would be that that Ms. Powell uses a licensed contractor.
Right.
There may be a question of whether this year's license fee has...
The contract actually requires that he be licensed.
And just to discuss that with James, James is proactively helpful in these matters. And
they're not familiar, you know, I'm not familiarized with them. They might have to acquire their license. If they acquired it last year, I don't believe they renewed this year. They would have to renew their license.
Right, because see, he did all the tuck pointing, replacement of bricks, and actually the roofing, and he had permits.
But you'll check. We'll leave that at this point, Mr. Smith, if we could.
Yeah, it's not something that we're, I mean, obviously, it's just a reminder to Ms. Powell to make sure they're licensed, because that'll just slow it down, and we don't, during the construction season, it's always better to keep pushing along. So we have no problem.
But that if that isn't, for instance, if he comes in on the 10th and those things aren't straight, it might push it back to the 30th. So it'd be good to have him get in early and...
All right, because see, in the contract that we have, it requires that he be licensed and also pull all the.
But I guess what I'm saying is, if James can get back to you tomorrow, he can check as to whether he's currently. James, isn't that true? You can check whether he's currently licensed.
Okay.
And get back to Ms. Powell. Do you have one another's contact information?
Pardon me?
Do you and James have one another's contact information?
Yeah, I spoke with him last week. Right, I spoke with him last week.
And he has your phone, in other words, to get back and forth. And just lean on Tellez to, after you've talked to James, mm-hmm. if Tellez does need to renew this year, then all to... Right.
And otherwise, President, we would be fine with this as a status report. We look forward to a further status at the July meeting and would ask that it be reset for July for a further status, and hopefully this will be done. I know the building commissioner would like to then see what the plans are for the inside.
If we find that the permits issued and the man's license, can we extend it to 60 days, do
sure,
you think?
August.
Because that'll give him a chance to have done some of it.
Let me use your pen. Can you correct and just put the June,
I
July?
July.
Okay. All right. So it's July.
It.
That's correct. Yeah.
So we'll do 60 days. So the August meeting, if Tellez is licensed. If they're not, we'd like the status in July.
Okay, that'd be fine, because I also intend to set up a meeting with the commissioner to show her the plans as to
good.
We intend
okay.
to progress.
Often James is at those meetings.
All right.
Yes, sir, Deputy.
All right.
Thank you.
Okay.
It kind of helps to move things along that the operating staff keeps in touch with her as far as understanding.
I spoke with him, and he's the one that told me she was on vacation.
Right. She would be here otherwise. She doesn't like to pay him overtime if she can avoid it.
I told him I'll go ahead and print up what I had to submit here today.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
All right. Thank you.
May I ask the two ladies what they're here about and just
yes.
which property?
The garage.
3932 McCook.
Is that on your list? Mr. Smith, come
yes,
forward, and perhaps we can get this one done at this time also.
Yes.
Is this status or?
It's, it's status. It is status, Mr. President.
Just
waiting on Mr. Solis. I have the permit and everything. I told him I wouldn't have the money till the second week of June, so that's what the holdup was.
What's the date on that permit? We were wondering about that.
Issue 419.
Yeah, so that the concern of the commissioner in the building department is just that it's been pulled for almost... well, we're going up on 90 days, and I understand that it was a money issue, but so I'm
yes.
looking forward to an update on that.
We can mark that date in concrete and...
On the 17th, I paid him half.
Yes, Mrs. Jackson is showing me a document with Solis General Construction showing that half has been paid on June 17th. Looks like a balance of
$2,500.
Yes. Solis is licensed and dependable? Okay. Very good.
Did he give you a start update?
No, he said he had to get his crew together, that he had quite a few jobs, so.
Yeah, we'll give him a call, but I know that's under concern.
Yeah, it's definitely, it's right next to Ivy Tech. We want to try to get that fixed up, and I'm happy to see that the homeowners are working towards that. So if we could set it for status in July.
And thank you very much for coming.
Thank you.
So code enforcement, if we could have Mr. Arredondo, and then we'll give the floor to you, Mr. Smith.
That's
for
fine.
The
thank you.
Miguel Arredondo.
Returning now to the regular agenda.
Thank you.
Right. Thank you, Mr. Arredondo.
I submitted to Ms. Cosby my status report for the month of June. Hopefully a gentleman had time to look at it over and if you have any questions. It's our summer months. Very, very busy. The most busiest time of the year for code enforcement. Basically, identifying the rank vegetation, overgrown weeds throughout the city. You'll have a lot of, we receive calls, I would say approximately anywhere from 12 to 15 a day of people who have had problems. I try to explain to them the process, and since this is something that's televised, maybe it might be helpful just to understand that once we receive a complaint, but more than not, what we have been doing in the past few years is we actually drive and go through an entire street, such as if I'm going to go down First Street, I don't want to go to 38th and Fur and then the 39th and Fur and then the 42nd. You know? So what we do is we'll start at the 3500 block of Fur and go all the way down till we get to the end of Fur, which is in right by Washington Park. Document every property that we see with overgrown vegetation. And by city ordinance, that's anything over the 6 inches. We understand that it's been a lot of heavy rain this year. So we try to give them a little bit of leeway there. We can tell if somebody is cutting their grass regularly, even if it gets overgrown. As you know, it rained yesterday, it rained today. So if you didn't have time to get home today, in about 8 to 9 days, you will have overgrown vegetation. We don't bother those folks because we can see that they are cutting their grass regularly. It's the ones that we address have been probably not cut since the beginning of the year or one time since the beginning. A lot of them are our landlords who are out-of-towners or our vacant properties. We identify them, then have to send a letter to the owner, giving them a required 5 days to remove and abate the violation. And at that time, we come and do a reinspection. After the reinspection date, then we will also make out a work order and send it to our Public Works Department for them to remove it. At that point, code enforcement is basically finished with it. As far as when are they going to cut it, I can't tell you that. All I can tell you is as long as we sent them the work order, they will get to it as soon as possible. I can tell you that just between last week and this week, I issued about 185 orders. So it's not something that comes in small batches or something that I know that if you live next door to it, it's something that's bothersome. But we do the city. We just don't do it, parcel at a time. So sometimes you think it may not be getting done quick enough, and I apologize for that. But I hope that I have the residents have understanding that this is the best we're doing at this time.
What then for the next time? It has to go through the same process? If I may, as a hypothetical, where somebody's moved on, it's vacant, will it then be rescheduled, or do you have to go through all the paper again as if you had done nothing before to get that cut again a second time?
I believe that someone in Indianapolis must have had a problem and probably farther south in Lake County.
Okay.
Because they changed this law. I did have an Illinois attorney send me a paper to tell me you didn't notify my client like you should have, and I sent them
each time.
Right. Okay. And I sent them a copy of the law and say, read one law behind it, that it changed it, that once you've made proper notification once, that after that, you can continue to remedy the violation if it's not. This happens basically in 99% of the time only in the abandoned properties, because even properties that are rentals, if a guy's renting the property, he's got somebody coming in, or maybe we have to give him the first time, maybe we have to cut it the first time, but nobody wants to keep paying that bill over and over. It's the ones who are vacant. We don't own it. I lost it on foreclosure. The bank still hasn't picked it up. The banks in Wyoming, Idaho, and wherever else we have them. We keep doing that, but with the new law, all I do then is just set out the work order. Take a picture of it. We always take that picture to show that why we say it was in violation. And we just, a good example is right by where we're staying at, that corner house. Because I sent
them. I didn't want to bring it up.
Because I sent them the initial letter. After it got through a certain violation, all I did now is send out the work order, which I sent that out 2 days ago.
Okay. Any house near you?
No, they keeping it up pretty good right now.
I guess Mike and I are the only people who have to suffer.
But, you know, a good indication of that is to show you that 2 years ago, that didn't happen anywhere close in that area. Things like that are starting to because of people losing houses, foreclosing on houses, moving and things. So
that really areas, was that was one of the nicest houses in the subdivision.
That we did not deal with 4 years ago, we're dealing with now.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. Arredondo. We'll accept the your report. I'll move that we accept Mr. Arredondo's report. Second?
I second
the
motion.
Roll call.
Richard Morrisville.
Accept.
Thomas Davis.
Accept.
Richard Chemzinski.
Accept.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Mr. Smith for the Building Department status report.
Yes, I have a couple properties and then
just if you could identify yourselves.
Sure, Kevin Smith on behalf of the Building Commissioner, Ms. Guzman. I have a couple properties to update the board on. There's also some requests from the Building Commissioner through James here, and he's going to speak to a couple other properties as well and probably help steer me along too. The first is 4021 Carey. This is a property that the board has already entered an order of demolition and was recorded in January of 2013. This is a property that is currently owned by Walking by Faith Ministries, NFP, and Pastor Renee Chandler. I spoke with Pastor Chandler today, and he indicated to me he was asking for further time because he believes the church may be getting a grant in October, and he also said that they're trying to look for some purchasers. Now, we have heard this, the grant is a new issue, but we have heard this for some time that Pastor Chandler is trying to look for some purchasers of this.
I believe they were building. Here the last meeting.
They have shown up before, that's true. It's an unfortunate situation because I think, you know, the Building Commissioner's position is we'd like to get moving on this property. It's unsightly, it boarded up. The windows are a mess, and we'd like to move forward. However, Pastor Chandler has indicated, you know, and he has made the effort to show up, which is always better than just, you know, not showing up, obviously. And so I guess we'd leave it up to the board. James, do you have anything else to add on that from the Building Commissioner's perspective?
Building Commissioner's stand on it would be to move on with the demolition proceedings. The pastor did call today, but I didn't get to communicate with him. He called right, you know, before the meeting. But I could, as far as what Weena has mentioned, we've entered that order in September 2012. We allowed it to continue June 2013. Nothing has been done in regards to that property. It is in deteriorated condition. It would be hurt.
It was given to the church?
It was actually bought on tax sale by the pastor's dentist, who then donated it to the church.
Okay.
It's in
and it's a bad state of cavity.
You could say that.
Condition. Her request would be for the to move on with the demolition proceedings.
Well, at least to communicate with the pastor tomorrow and to see if that, you know, to let him know what's happening, and that that you have given us the status and that you really see no alternative unless he provides it.
Well, the next step would be to bid out the work, so that would be the next step, and he would have time between now and then to communicate with Ms. Guzman. We already have the order. The board's already acted.
Okay. Next one?
Next one's 3938 Pulaski. I'm happy to report to the board that the owners have been progressing steadily on this property, and work is ongoing, and we hope that at the July status, we are able to say that work is complete. It's moving forward nicely. You may remember this family, the Gonzalez's.
The next door neighbors were very interested in something happening.
Yeah, so it's and it is happening, so it's good news.
Good. Okay.
And then I'm done, but James has 5017 Indianapolis. I was mistaken that actually the demolition order on that property, that's the communication you had, Mr. Morris wrote.
Yes. Yes.
From Senator Randolph's client. Their demolition order was entered at the May 2013 meeting, so just last month. I wasn't at that meeting, that's why it didn't click in my head, but James has an update on that as well.
James?
Okay. Yes, the commissioner asked me to bring it before. Obviously, it had been continuous in February 22, 2012 for 90 days. Since then, it has expired. As of today, the owner has failed to comply, submit plans, construction design release, etc. The structure continues to further deteriorate. The structure, how bad the conditions are there. The demolition order was entered at May 2013, so building department is requesting that the board execute the order to demolish.
Any questions? As I say, I had mentioned earlier, Mrs. Garza sent a letter. It is nothing substantive other than to continue to tell us the travails of her and her husband. I frankly fail to see why these prevent any action from occurring on her part other than asking for time.
We've given
as she has for 10 years.
We needed it several times. We're really asking for...
Well, just make sure you notice Attorney Randolph as well as, if you need to double notice, even if it's an extra step, please do it so that...
make sure he gets a copy of the order, order that the board affirmed, as well as, of course, he'll get, if the building commissioner and the board are so inclined and the mayor, that to move forward with the bidding process.
He was here last time with her. And again, the irony is she has this gifted architect nephew who tells her what she can do but doesn't get done or doesn't get someone to help her get it done. And as a result, she's regularly telling us about all the talent available, but the talent never gets to work.
Well, the unfortunate thing is that the community has to suffer as well.
And we've had a number of complaints. I've had some people very firmly tell us to move on this. So continue to move, but just make sure you notice properly, even if it's the extra step, just so that she can't start later coming and whining to the world that Mr. Randolph knew, but I didn't know. I just think it's in all of our interest to double serve in this case.
Okay.
And to list that you're, the one to Randolph to list her, and on the one to her to list Randolph. So that
list everybody on one.
Yeah.
We're all listed.
That's fine.
All right. Thank you.
Another status, which we 4933 Alexander's a commercial property. This was an emergency order to demolish. The structure has caved in, roof collapsed, walls are buckling. It's a real deteriorated condition. Building department has requested demolition proposals. Citations were issued to the owner, and we're pending the demolition by the owner within 1 or 2 weeks. Nothing has occurred up to this point now, but it is an emergency order due to the conditions of that building. As far as...
We needn't take any action at this point.
No. Just the status. And 3932 McCook was here, so we talked about that.
We talked about that.
Okay. I think we've covered everything.
The 4006 Alexander...
I don't believe that is.
That wasn't on our list.
It simply says construction design release pending.
I believe, if I'm not mistaken, that the we received some email from the state on attempt for construction design release, and maybe they're requesting for more, but they are, we're in the process of
we needn't take any action on it.
But no actions need to be taken.
Okay. Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Any old business?
None that I know of.
Any other business? Like our next regular meeting to take place on July the 10th at the same time, 5:30. Same place, your city council chambers. Entertain a motion to adjourn.
Make a motion to adjourn.
Second.
Roll call.
Richard Morrisroll.
Adjourn.
Thomas Davis.
Adjourn.
Richard Trumzinski.
Adjourn.
Thank you all for being here, and our meeting of the East Chicago Board of Public Safety is here for adjourn. Thank you.